The situation in Imbale City is truly dire. Everywhere you turn, there are polythene bags, bottles and waste originating from homes, shops and markets. The pervasive smell might lead one to believe they have stumbled into a sewage plant. The once renowned cleanest city in Uganda and East Africa now faces a pressing challenge that demands urgent attention.
But as for now, I think it is the dirtiest now. But the challenge is, I think it is the leadership.
Chafu wembali, na ye onongawa ya ingide wabe watu nde moto kebio nene vitipa vyaku, nenga container zari mu.
The residents are pointing fingers at political leaders. However, the political leaders are shifting blame onto the community. The leaders claim to have conducted extensive sensitization efforts, yet the community is purportedly failing to comply with the new regulations governing the elevated city of Mbale.
All the communities keep thinking that waste management is the responsibility of government, which is council. So I must generate and put it there, and someone should. See, I think the colonial way things were done, and somehow the attitude kept on building and people kept on believing that maybe once I pay a certain tax, government should come and clean up. So that mentality, that attitude.
And you who is talking about council, you're also part of council. Let us love our town. Let us clean our town. It is a collective responsibility. Council is doing all that whatever it can to make sure that Mbale City is clean.
We are moving from talking to working, from sensitizing to demonstrating how it is done.
Under these circumstances, the NEMA team under the Yonja Uganda, also referred to as the Anti-Litter and Waste Management Campaign, led by the Executive Director of NEMA, the Corporate Communications Manager and the Senior Legal Counsel, have stepped in to carry out sensitization campaigns. Their objective is to educate people across various regions of Uganda on appropriate actions and to reinforce their responsibilities as both leaders and members of the communities.
Plastic could be cloth. Some of the clothes are made out of synthetic. When those break down and we throw carelessly, those are in the general environment. They break down and become microplastics. Now, when it rains, those are washed in streams and we consume them. The fish we eat consumes them. The water, some people consume water directly from streams.
Yeah. Littering waste and the lack of where to deposit the waste appears to be the primary contributor to the problem of cleanliness in various cities and towns across Uganda. In our pursuit of understanding the legal perspective on this matter, we reached out to the Senior Legal Counsel at NEMA. We sought clarification on the legal repercussions for individuals found guilty of littering and inquired about the associated penalties.
The law provides for the punishment. It is either in monetary terms, 550 currency points, and one currency point is an equivalent of 20,000 Uganda shillings. So you get that money and you do the calculations. That amounts 11 million if you're found littering.
The Yonja Uganda, also known as Anti-Litter and Waste Management Campaign, continues with recent efforts targeting Namawojolo Market, Mbale City, and Toro Municipality. However, it's crucial to acknowledge the dire circumstances facing several towns and cities across Uganda. Urgent attention is required to address the escalating waste management issues in these areas. Without swift action, these regions are at risk of facing a health crisis. Report compiled by Jimmy Luima for the news.